Yeah, that sad time of year when you gotta start thinking about putting your bike up for the winter time, and that's it for the riding. Pegs down, pegs down. Responding with a roar. Tires spitting gravel as the engine cries for more. Getting ready for that little portion of the year that's known as death. December all the way through May. As I said, we might get lucky and get a couple nice days, and who knows? excuse me. Right now, Daddy's hungry. Daddy needs some food. I think I'll go top her off. Get some stabilizer. Get ready just in case she's gonna be sitting for a while. Kind of wanted to talk about like your job, or anybody out there, when you do something, do you throw yourself 100% into it, or you just kind of half-ass it, or is it kind of like, it depends on your mood, if you're doing your hobby, or even at work, you just kind of show up and mail it in? Or I know everybody does that every now and again. Just feeling a little bit underneath the weather, or it's like the day before vacation when you're at work, or day before weekend. You just kind of like do what you have to do. You don't fucking do it too much more than that. Well, some people, depending on who you are and how much you care what people think about you. Some people always kind of half-ass it, and there's always those people that like go all out no matter what they're involved in or what they're doing. Kind of go that extra mile just because they give a shit what people think about them, not necessarily because they want praise or anything. It's just like, if you're gonna do something, do it right, or do it to the best of your abilities 100%. It's kind of like, even if you're not too good, like when you first start working at a job that you might not be familiar with, it's kind of like on the job training kind of a situation. Like you're moving, you or even at the place that at a place that you work, you're going to another job there. If you're kind of vaguely familiar with that, or you're not familiar with that job or machine at all. It's like just giving a shit kind of like makes up for lack of experience or knowledge about something. And that I suppose that applies to everything. Not just work, but like no matter what you do in life, it's like if you care, that makes up for a lot of stuff that you might not know, like far as like knowledge or experience with something. And that makes all the difference in the world. Where I work, it's like we have like a lot of people that are floaters or GLs. Go get me some McDoubles. I love McDoubles. And that goes a long way with somebody that you're working with. That like, get out there.
Later, please.
As far as like not knowing something or having little knowledge about something, if you just like are willing to learn, and listen and show a little bit of fucking ambition, that goes a long way with somebody. Like, I would rather work with somebody that is anxious to help out any way they can and put forth an effort at least. And I guess I'm telling you the story because there's a lot of people I work with who are going to remain nameless, but they just kind of mail it in. They just kind of like, I'm a GL, I don't know a lot about this machine, I don't give a shit about it, and I don't give a shit about how much work you have to do or how hard your job is. I'm going to do whatever is easier for me. Well, I'm going to go in and get some food, so I'll continue on with my story once I get out.
Eventually.
Well, anyways, like I was saying, somebody that comes into your situation, like say at work or whatever, and they're not that experienced, and like I said, in this GL situation, general labor pool, or laborers, they sometimes have a tendency to be like, don't show me what's going on, I don't care, whatever. And I think that's fucking horseshit, because it's like, just show a little initiative. It's like, I understand that this isn't your job, but regardless if you want to learn something or not, if you're working with me, you're going to learn, because A, you'll be better off, because the next time you come in here, you'll know what's going on and have a better understanding of what's going on. And B, it's going to be easier for me because I don't have to sit there and babysit your dumbass.
Yeah.
But some people just don't understand that shit. Whatever. I kind of blame the powers that be for that situation because they don't kind of pay attention to that shit. They don't have to deal with it, so they don't care. They're just like, just get your job done. And I think that's just kind of, like I said, that's bad, because more responsibilities put on the machine operator to perform, to pick up the slack for these useless people.
It had never been about that. Never been about playing no shit.
But oh well. It's a glorious day for a November 29th, and I should be happy, not bitching.
Yes.
So anyways, sun shining. It's like, weatherman's full of shit though, because it's like, maybe in the high 40s. It's still kind of chilly out, but I'm going to be praying for this kind of shit in the next couple of weeks, probably. Yeah, is what it is, living in the upper Midwest. Sucks ass. Summers are awesome. Winters are too fucking long and shitty. But oh well. Take a little ride around the fucking airport. Just giving a shit about things. Giving a shit about what people think about you. True champions, in my opinion, people that like just care, show a little bit of initiative. And I hate to say it though, majority of these people are millennials.
I get to take them down.
Give me the participation award. My dad always used to tell me when I was younger too, when I'd be slacking in school or whatever. You know what? No matter what you do in life, I'm gonna love it, he used to tell me. You can be the CEO of a company, or the guy that picks little fucking black curly hairs on the urinals in the bathrooms for that company, and I'll still love you just the same. Doing well. asshole. Do the best job you can. You're gonna suck fucking dick? You suck the best fucking dick ever.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy!
You're crazy, man.
I think Jen's been on, show her some love. Like I said, it's been a couple of weeks. My last fucking vlog, I was like, this is probably the last time I'm taking out. Well, I was full of shit. And some earlier videos I put out too. Just because I won't be riding my bike during the winter months doesn't mean I still won't be doing some talking head videos or some like updates on the bike. Like I plan on doing a few things that I can do with my limited mechanical talents to Jezebel. And I'll probably do some instructional shit, you know, on things I'm doing to my bike and just general interest shit. Maybe do some like reviews on some stuff. I don't know. Still up in the air. Like I said, I don't really plan anything out. I just get inspiration from other from things. And then, like, I'll get a wild hair in my ass. And, like, I'll throw a little fucking video together, whatever. Plan on doing more adventure stuff this next riding season. Going more places, more events, car shows, bike shows, meetups. More dual vlogs with Grimmy Grom and some other folks I know. There's one motor vlogger that's from this area that I've been trying to get something going, but it's like our just schedules don't mesh up. And it'd be kind of nice to do like a cabin fever kind of thing during this winter and like all get together and maybe do like a live thing where we all sit around and just talk and shit, and then like people can like join in live, do a live stream. That'd be pretty fucking cool. Yeah, boy! So I'm talking about that fairing, that Memphis Shades fairing I'm gonna get. I'm still kind of like torn between two of them. I don't know if I'm going to get the gauntlet fairing, which is like a one-third fairing, or more like a cafe racer kind of bullet-style bikini fairing. I'm thinking now I'm going to go more with the gauntlet because it's going to fit the style of bike, the style I want to go for. I just joined this forum. It's a street bob forum, but it's like all Harleys, but it's mostly Dynamite models and just people talking about stuff and sharing information and advice and all that other good kind of shit, and that's pretty cool. So I'm kind of like getting into that for the past couple of days. Kind of like getting me pumped up for doing mods to my own bike. Kind of like pushing me to do it a little bit more because I kind of keep on putting that shit off because it's like, eh. I don't have money right now, but so I'm gonna actually start. Like I said, I've been kind of picking up some more hours at work, so I can start actually doing some of this stuff. Now I got a little revenue built up off to the side. I'm gonna start slowly buying parts and stuff, and saving up to get some stuff powder coated and carbon fiber shit I've been wanting to get for a while.
I like it a lot.
Yeah, Daddy was basically just hungry and wanted some fucking Mickey D's, so that one out. I'm gonna start up an Instagram account. Like little extra shit that like pictures and stuff and little extra shit you don't see on this channel, you'll be able to see that stuff. Kind of more day of the life of KK2-1. I feel good. Get out right a little bit. All you that live in southern states, I fucking hate you. No, I'm just kidding. I love y'all. I just envy your asses. Upper Midwest living, man. You kind of get used to this shit. Like I said, I'm not going to let that slow me up. I get a nice day where the roads are dry. Even if it's in the fucking 30s or 40s, I'll still fucking go out. That's how I roll. Fucking ride every day, homie. Yeah, boy. Hook her back up. Hook Buttercup back up. Hey, get ready for this, Jezebel. Oh, yeah. Gonna fucking put it in there. You see this? Oh, yeah. Ready? Oh, I know. You're so fucking tight. Oh, Jezebel. Oh, you're so tight. Oh, fuck yeah.
2020, but I can't see nobody.
So, you like what you saw today? Tippity tap that fucking like button. And if you haven't already, subscribe to KK2-1. Tell all your friends. I need the fucking subs. Alright, well, that's just about it. And God bless all of you. And the Green Bay Packers. KK out.